Hi everyone, I'm Vandana Rai from Immigration Advisors New Zealand, and I was making this video to tell you all about the NZQA changes, the changes that NZQA has recently done with the COVID-19 restrictions. So there would be students who would have their IELTS or their English proficiency test expired by the time their course starts. There would be students who would have been planning to do another test in between their programs just to be eligible for their next higher level diploma. And then with this close down, they are unable to get those tests done. So recently NZQA has made some changes so that these students are not disadvantaged, and I'll tell you in detail all about that. So the first change that has recently the NZQA has done is that if you have an offer of place from an education provider and then the start date got deferred. So if your start date has got deferred you are expecting your IELTS to expire or your any other English proficiency test to expire by the time your course starts. So in this scenario, the education providers would accept your even the expired language proficiency test. So just relax, one less thing for you to be stressed about. Even if your English proficiency test expires after you've got the offer of place and before you could start your program, that test would still be considered by your education provider, and you would not be required to do another English proficiency test. Provided that the deferred intake is less than 12 months from the first offer that you were given. And definitely things would resolve within these 12 months, so nothing for you to worry. And then there are some students who've studied one program onshore, and they were planning to do their next higher level diploma, and they were planning to sit for an English proficiency test when this close down happened. And with this COVID-19 restriction, most of the language proficiency tests have the centers are closed, and you cannot sit for or make an arrangement to book your test for now till the time the restrictions are over. So what happens to those students? Another good news for you, NZQA has confirmed that they would still be accepting the alternate tests that are in the rule 18 of their site. So if those tests are online tests, they would be accepted. So for all those onshore students who are unable to book their IELTS, who are unable to book a PT exam, just relax. One option for you could be the language cert. It's an online test, and all you need is a system, all you need is a webcam and your system with you, and a Wi-Fi and an internet connection. So you can still take that online test and be eligible for your next higher level diploma. Any other question that you have pertaining to your language proficiency test with this COVID-19 restriction, please do ask me, and I'll make an endeavor to either answer you personally or make another video and let you know what the options could be for you. Stay safe everyone, and be as less stressed as possible. Thank you.